One of our first really significant incidents happened to be an officer-involved shooting.
Oklahoma City 911.
Came in as a disturbance call.
Are you having beef with someone up the road? You got any weapons? Can I pat you down real quick? Make sure you don't have any weapons. Here, don't reach for nothing. Oh! Oh! Gunfire! Gunfire! He's running down 21st.
There's an exchange of gunfire.
Suspect looks like he was hit.
Two drones responded.
74 said he ran in the backyard back here.
All right, George 36 is in out there with the drone.
There's another drone out here as well, correct?
You're tactically going to make different choices, not knowing if the suspect is still armed or not.
Hey, he's in the backyard.
He's laying down. He's on the far side.
By the use of the drone, you're able to direct the officers to the suspect.
This is his house. He's on the far side, right here. He's right there.
Okay.
You're able to see that he's unarmed.
Let me see your hands!
Getting in close right now.
I don't see anything in the hands.
Hands look open. They're above his head right now. He's laying down.
Keeping the officer safe and also keeping that suspect safe, getting him definitive medical care once he's in custody. The drones as a whole, especially for our department, has been a night and day difference. They are used daily in multiple divisions, in multiple shifts. My name's Dax Laporte, been a police officer with Oklahoma City for approximately 26 and a half years now.
Every tool is a piece of the puzzle on how do I keep the community safe. I'm Jason Bussert. I'm the captain over IT here at Oklahoma City Police Department. Being able to talk to the community and going, this is what we're doing to help you all, is putting the right people in the right situations with the right information so that we have better outcomes.
Whenever we're getting them initially trained, you try and introduce them to as much as possible. And so they get classroom setting, a stick time setting, to comfortably prepare them while out on patrol.
We have people who need air support immediately. If someone's injured and they need help and we can't find them, seconds matter. It's an amplifier of the manpower that we have on the streets because they know where the person is. They can see it as they arrive because we have live view, live streaming. Talking with the team, talking with the officers in the field, they went, we really just want one in our hands. And that made sense to me.
Oklahoma City's been fortunate enough to do the patrol-led deployment where we've been able to put multiple cases in patrol cars out on the streets at any given time.
We've been called here today for a suspect in the woods, ran from officers. Gonna deploy the drone.
My name is Sergeant Cameron Kyle. I'm a patrol officer with Spring Lake Division. Day-to-day agenda is patrol, respond to dangerous situations, and deploy a drone if needed. What's good about Skydio is the use of it is very easy. Let's stand clear, make sure everything's safe. Deploying the drone would be a little more officer safety just in case he's hiding behind a tree, behind some bushes, or up in a tree. Without using a drone, we would have the perimeter set up. An officer would go with K9 and that could take hours searching a field this size. This is quick and it's another tool for the officers to use. Recording this whole incident. Yeah, you can zoom in pretty close. During the winter time, this thing will pick up excellent. You'll see his feet prints walking out to it. It's pretty cool. That him right there. Hey, we got him. We got him. We can get K9. Just straight west and you'll run into him.
Oklahoma City Police Department K9 unit! Come out now, you might be bad!
When K9 starts walking, we'll stay with them. We're looking. If we see something ahead of them, we're going to notify them so they know what to expect.
And right now, we'd be radioing straight ahead.
K9 unit is arriving on scene. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, God.
And he just bit him.
Hold him, buddy. Hold him. Don't. Out. Heel.
We'll normally trail them until they get back. After that, we come back and land, and it'll automatically upload to Skydio and Axon, and then we just knock out a report of what we did.
My goal for Oklahoma City is to have the technology working for the officers and not the officers working for technology. Everything in my ecosystem has to work together. We have to look at really what helps the community and what helps keep our officers safer.
A lot of the technological advancements that we've made has been Captain Bussert, my direct captain, his ability to think outside the box. What can I do to the police department right now that is going to leave it in a better position, not when I leave, but 5 and 10 years down the road after I've already left?
We've done the drone and the truck, and they've been incredibly effective. We've had so many success stories with this. To be able to tie that into DFR drones as a first responder, having drones on top of buildings that can respond to a call without an officer. Now we've increased the availability for officers for situations that they really need to be hands-on. That's my vision for the next step. That's where we're headed. We have to look at, does this help our officers? Does this help our community? This vision does.
You got a drone in the area now.